Let us give thanks, each in our own way. On this day of celebration and achievement, we give our thanks for the rich inheritance we have received from this university, for the insight and imagination of others, and for friendship shared. We give thanks especially for the support of family and friends who encourage us to achieve our goals. Bless all our graduates today as they journey forth from here, those who will use their imagination and curiosity for learning in seeking to address the needs of the world. May they use their creativity and vision as they inspire and guide others on the paths of discovery and learning. Grant those who will frame our laws, shape our nation's policies, and work together for the common good, wisdom to see clearly, and strength to act rightly in their search for truth and justice. We give thanks for all our graduates. May they meet each new opportunity with a bold and daring spirit, and may they find great happiness in all that they do. Amen.
Please be seated. I now call on the Principal and Vice-Chancellor to address this assembly.
Chancellor Bailey Helen Wright, graduands and all guests, welcome to the Caird Hall, welcome to Dundee, evidentially the sunniest city in Scotland. In case you're wondering, there's a window there, I can see the weather outside. Well, we may or may not be the sunniest city in Scotland, meteorologically that's the case, but I can tell you for sure, inside this hall, we're the sunniest city in Scotland, the sunniest place anywhere, to see all of the faces of the graduands about to cross the stage to become graduates of this great university, the University of Dundee. So I'm going to speak a little bit about the ceremony that you're about to participate in. And set the tone, I hope, for what we're going to do this afternoon. The first thing to say is, I know there'll be nerves out there, but we need to get past the nerves and into doing one thing and one thing only, and that's celebrating. This is a celebration. This is a celebration of your achievement, for you, for all your loved ones here, and we're here to help you celebrate. So make noise. I've been told that the loudest concert in this hall was 1971, is that right, Rector? When The Who played here. Well, I remember rock bands of the 1970s, and what I remember is that after the second song, could have been anything, couldn't hear a thing. However, we think you can do better than that. We think that you can really raise the roof of the Caird Hall. You, graduands, all of your friends, loved ones around. We want you to make noise, to cheer, to clap, to whoop, to stamp your feet. If you want to have a little dance come across the stage, provided, number one, you do it safely so you don't harm or hurt yourself, watch out for the maces, they're heavy, don't bump into them. And number two, you keep going so the next person can follow you, then have a blast. And friends and family upstairs in the balcony, it's great to see the hall so full this afternoon, but I assure you, as you stamp your feet, and this lot behind are pretty good at stamping their feet, so you can do better, as you stamp your feet and make noise, the balcony will not collapse. It's okay, it's a solid old concert hall. More seriously, we really genuinely want you to have the best possible time. In fact, it's a pretty full hall. So we think you can probably get pretty close to that kind of biggest noise ever in here. And the Chancellor and I, we have a little bet. I know you wouldn't believe that gentlemen like us would indulge in such things, but we have a little bet, which is which of the graduation celebrations can make the most noise. And I think you could do it today. So we need to see if you can. So let's get a little bit of a practice going, so that it's not just the youngest people in the audience that are making noise, which is excellent, but everyone else is as well. So let's count you in on three, and let's get a practice to get this ceremony warmed up. As much noise as we can, class of 2024. One, and two, and three! What do you think, Chancellor?
I think they can do better.
You think they can? I think you're right. I'm quite confident, but I think they can do better. We'll just test them again in a little while, see if they maybe warmed up a little bit. So, graduates, you've made it. You're here. And it's taken incredible dedication, incredible commitment to get to this stage. For some of you, for many of you, you've had to contend with an additional burden of COVID, so the COVID-19 pandemic. That's changed so much in the way you've had to deal with your studies, not just your studies, but also dealing with, well, all parts of life. It seems in a way a long time ago, but actually it's still very, very recent. And of course, as you all know, COVID-19 is still out there. So the fact that you have got here now is an incredible testament to that resilience, to that dedication, to that focus. And I want to say that I am proud of every one of you, each and every one of you seated here in front of me today. You've shown amazing resilience, amazing determination. Really well done. Cheer again. Come on. I don't know, Chancellor, I think they're going to be a tough audience, this lot, really. We're going to have to work harder.
Yeah, they're getting better, but, you know, a wee bit too old.
A bit more impromptu is what we need, really, don't we?
Yeah. Absolutely. Especially during your speech, yeah.
Well, especially during my speech, yeah. I mean, there's no interruptions. So, let's talk a bit about the ceremony that you're going to go through. You're going to cross the stage, and you'll come on one side as graduand, and the other side as graduate. And apart from that, keeping going, don't stop the flow, there is one really important thing you have to remember. You get your degree by being doffed by the Chancellor with the bonnet, with the Dundee bonnet. This Dundee bonnet's been used at every graduation since the University of Dundee became an independent institution in 1967. It was made by the nine trades, the Dundee bonnet makers, first wielded by our first Chancellor, Queen Elizabeth, the Queen Mother, and now by our illustrious Chancellor, Lord George Robertson. And I'll say something more about the Chancellor later. Now, you do have to stop in order for the Chancellor to doff you. And there's a couple more things to remember when a Chancellor doffs you. Number one, he has amazing reach as a person, but his arms are a finite length, okay? So get close enough so he can actually doff you. And secondly, the golden rule. No selfies with the Chancellor. Plenty chances to get pictures and have fun elsewhere, but please do keep the flow going. So you'll be doffed, you'll pass the university mace. That's the mace closest to me on my left, on your right. That mace is the symbol of the degree awarding power of the University of Dundee. It's been at every graduation since we were initiated as University College Dundee. It's been there for 110 years. And together, it's with the mace of the city of Dundee, which is the next one along. Our association with our city, of Dundee and for Dundee, has always been incredibly close, and is exemplified by the mace here and the presence of Bailie Helen Wright, who, as well as being a huge supporter of our university in every way, you can see is even dressed for the occasion in Dundee blue. We love our city, and our city loves us. And finally, this mace on the right. In a way, this is the most important mace of all, because this is the rector's mace. Our esteemed rector, wearing his own Dundee bonnet, is sitting just to my right. The rector looks after the interests of all of you and all the students that come after you. He is your representative here on the stage, making sure that we do things well. And our rector knows about a good stage show, don't you, rector? So, you'll pass the maces, you'll be doffed with the bonnet. And the last thing you'll be wondering, perhaps or perhaps not, is the significance of these robes. They're very grand, very beautiful robes. You've all been here long enough to know that this is indeed the blue colour associated with our university. But actually, the reason for this blue, it's called liturgical blue, is this is the colour associated with the patron saint of Dundee, St. Mary the Virgin. And also associated with St. Mary the Virgin is the Madonna Lily, or the fleur-de-lis, which is also the symbol of our city. And then finally, well, we're a Scottish university, and I can think of no symbol that shows the resilience that you've shown better than the thistle on the ropes. So that's a history lesson. Let's come back to the present, to our university, to your university. You've been students here, you're graduands, and as graduates, you'll have a lifelong membership of this, your university. So let's talk about it a little bit. Our core values as a university are to transform lives here in Dundee and globally through the creation, the sharing, and the application of knowledge. We talk about being a triple intensive university. This means we combine our strengths in teaching and learning, research with impact, and enterprise and engagement with our community, all with a really strong commitment to what a great university exists to do: drive social purpose, create a vibrant future for all. Our university was co-founded in 1881 by Mary Ann Baxter, who was a great pioneer of gender equality in education. And I'm proud that as an institution, we continue to champion equity and inclusion in all its forms, be it through our Athena Swan Gold Award, our Race Equalities Charter, and a complete intolerance of racism in any form, and our now well-established Africa Initiative. And reflecting that set of values is very much our Chancellor, Lord George Robertson. George was installed as the sixth Chancellor of the University of Dundee in November last year. So this is Lord Robertson's first summer graduation. Well, actually, it's his second summer graduation. This is his first summer graduation in that chair. But George crossed the stage and graduated with an MA in economics himself back in, sorry to say this, George, 1968, even before the WHO made the rafters sing here. George began his political career, and as many of you will know, George has an incredibly illustrious political career behind him, and I'm sure before you as well, in many ways of influence, George. But he began that political career here in Dundee. Not just that, but he's been a champion of our values and of our university ever since he first crossed the stage. Because when George crossed the stage in 1968, he was part of the cohort of students who were the first to be offered a University of Dundee degree. In that year, students could choose a St. Andrews degree, or mother university or a Dundee degree. Not only did George choose the Dundee degree, but he championed Dundee and our degree for the values of our university, the closeness to our city, and also taking the best parts of our mother university. George, you have always been. You have always been. Please don't not interrupt. George has always been our champion, and it's such a pleasure and honour to have you here with us today. We are a community as a university, and that sense of community is vital to the city of Dundee, to the people of Dundee, to the ethos of Dundee, and you'll have seen that during your time here in our university, in our city. We've been core as a university to the transformation and the renaissance of Dundee. Hopefully you've spent some time at the waterfront, at the wonderful V&A Museum that the university helped bring to Dundee. It's really a transforming city, and we were delighted that we heard the announcement this week that the city has granted planning permission to bring the Eden Project here in Dundee. It's shining a beacon on the future of sustainability, and our university are really proud, very right, to be part of a partnership with the city in delivering that. As well as that close community with Dundee, we've taken Dundee to the world and we bring the world to Dundee. We can see it here. We're a truly global university. Students and staff from over 140 different countries around the world, many countries represented here amongst our graduands, audience, and indeed on the stage. Taking that triple intensity with social purpose out globally is vital to our sense of ourselves. And so we build strong and increasing equitable partnerships with partners around the world in countries like Nigeria, Malawi, China, India, Ghana, Singapore, Indonesia, Iraq, and many, many others. So what does that mean for you about to graduate, graduands coming from the School of Humanities, Social Sciences and Law? Well, we created the school quite recently to bring together disciplines from across the social sciences and humanities and related professional programs so that we could start to address in a really interdisciplinary way some of society's biggest questions. Our new Binks Institute for Sustainability will help lead our multidisciplinary responses to some of the big global challenges of today: climate change, climate justice. The new institute speaks to our mission to transform lives at a global scale. And I was really delighted that the Leverhulme Foundation awarded us an extraordinarily competitive grant to launch an exciting new large-scale PhD program linked to innovation and sustainability at the heart of what the city of Dundee is about. Our future educators and teachers, the graduands before us from these disciplines, you're part of a thriving community that has social purpose at your heart. You've already helped to transform lives through the placements that you've taken during your studies, and you will really be the heart of that education system going forward, making a lasting impact on the lives of future students and learners. The value of teaching is immeasurable. You will become the future ambassadors of the opportunity that education offers to guide the next generation to be responsible members of society. This year has also been a great success for our law school. Not only have we enjoyed the second year of a very successful professional mentorship program with some stunning alumni coming together to work with students, but we've also celebrated the opening of a new law center in February this year. Both of these events, both of these initiatives will help further support a much needed public service, working closely with the local businesses and alumni community and local people to provide access to justice for all and really enhance our university's commitment to support our graduates' employability as you step into your future careers. That focus on justice for all, that focus on opportunity, is incredibly well exemplified by our illustrious honorary graduand, who will be presented to you later in the ceremony. He's really an exemplar of ensuring that justice, equity, and fairness is applied to all in society. And it's a true privilege to honor him at any time, particularly today of all days on World Refugee Day. In facing the major challenges of today and tomorrow, in these both local and national and global contexts, society needs more innovative, more critical thinkers in order to deliver that fairer, more sustainable society, to give us that cultural understanding to help and build connections. Humanities, social sciences, law are all disciplines that will help us understand what motivates society and help educate and support all on the road to sustainability. All of you have a key role here in our collective future. All of you here today, the graduates that have gone before you, those that will follow you across the stage in years to come, you are our hope for the delivery of meaningful change on issues like inclusion, climate action, population health, and many, many other challenges. You are the next generation who will put your minds to helping solve some of these big issues. You'll have gained new knowledge and skills that now take you out into the world. And on a lighter note, but just as importantly, you'll have found new friends, hopefully lifetime friends, and perhaps even your life partners. Many on the stage here have found their life partners while here at Dundee. And whatever else you've done, you've certainly found out more about yourself. It's my most sincere hope that your time at this university, your university, has equipped you to take the step into the next stage of your lives with confidence, with a spirit of adventure. Be bold, be creative, be innovative, make your own impact. As graduates, you become global ambassadors with a lifelong membership of the University of Dundee. Your university, you're forever part of our community. I hope you'll take a pride in that membership. I hope you'll share your passion for your university and you'll maintain your connection with the city of Dundee in the years ahead. Be proud of what you've achieved. We are. I am. You are a credit to this university and to our wider community. I really look forward to hearing more about all of you, hopefully at the garden party this afternoon, but also as you go through the next stages in your lives. Stay close to us, but know that all of us here, your community of fellow graduates, students, staff, wish you the very, very best for your future. Now, you've been very well behaved and not interrupted me. But we do have a little matter of a wager to settle. And we need to move now our ceremony into the most important part, which is you graduating. So let's lift the tone. And here's your chance to really bring down, metaphorically, the roof in the Caird Hall, to get off to start a huge celebration. So I count to three again, and let's hear it from the class of 2024. One, and two, and three.
Thank you. It never ceases to amaze me how clever the principal is in getting applause for his speech this afternoon. Anyway, I now call on Professor Sarah Hendry from the School of Humanities, Social Science and Law to present the candidates.
Chancellor, I have the honour to present, for the degree of Bachelor of Laws with Honours, Surabi.
Matthew Adair. Adoronke Adewonen. Jaiolo Agoro. Celestina Agulo. Jacintha Ayeva. Raya Almascari. Laura Aliaj. Favour Anaya Lubetchi. Holly Barr. Rhiannon Black. Patrick Gleese. Anna Barbary. Manashwi Budisuki. Imran Chowdhury. Jen Lee Chong. Abby Christie. Mark Finnerty. Pierres Finucan. Karen Preet Gill. Lauren Gowdy. Leah Hawkins. Emma Helgeson. Rabia Hussein. Zachary Ingram. Hannah Jeffarelli. Arup Mansour. Kieran McManus. Rituja Nurvikar. Shivona Patel. Louise Raxter. Alison Riley. Junwen Yang. James Barron. William Herndon. Hassan Ali. Taco Daffy. Eri Slater. Juliet Addo. Shreya Bhandari. Aidan Callan. Molly Chater. Kieran Clare. Lauren Davis. Andrew Donnelly. Jessica Fulton Hawes. Linda Jitonga. Grace Good. Celine Grant. Freya Grant. Katrina Hackwood. Hamish Henderson. Lorena Hunter. Miles Ionetta. Sunidhi Kurup. Erin McInnes. Isla McLeod. Vasilios Maniakis. Amy Marsh. Kerry McCree. Sophia Mehdu. Gerber Purwal. Fraser Ramsey. Honam Sheikh. Hannah Stein. Michael White. Zoe Woods. James Abel. Faris Ahmed. Abby Aitken. Naya Akhtar. Zainab Aslam. Gaurav Bali. Caitlin Barnes. Nadia Blakey. Danielle Brownlee. Charlotte Burrows. Molly Castle. Alexandra Haji Anastasiadi. Lucy Connor. Ryan Coyle. Finlay Crowe. Ailsa Davidson. Emily Donaldson. Thomas Ferguson. Leah Finnegan. Annabella Graham. Shannon Houston. Hannah Genosi. Mia Jennings. Hannah Jordan. Aidan Kellock. Jason Kerr. Lauren Marr. Aisling McCusker. Saul McGivney. Kirsty MacLeod. Sean McPhillips. Adam Mustafa. Cameron Murchie. Mohammed Naeem. Mia Presley. Anissa Qureshi. Nafisa Shahzad. Brooke Shields. Emma Shotland. Sophie Snedden. Christopher Stewart. Megan Thompson. Gemma Tun. Olivia Waddle. Madita Vasim. Amy Watson. Charles Weir. Kieran Wilson. Yezzy Wood. Taylor Gray. Molly McGoran. Louise Kelly. Jessica Walker. And for the degree of the Master of Arts with Honours, Natalie Angus. Molly Bell. Kiva Bremner. Molly Buchanan. Kathleen Calderwood. Reagan Cook. Jesse Davey. Nikki Donnelly. Jennifer Edwards. Katrina Edgerton. Mary Foley. Melissa Foster. Katie Gall. Sarah Glass. Oh no, thank you. Piper Gillies. Sarah Glass. Keris Guild. Holly Hunter. Elise Ildever. Amy Kilgore. Jonathan Lavers. Cara Lorimer. Anastasia Martin. Cara McInnish. Kirsty McEwen. Eva McNaughton. Lisa Milne. Zoe Moreland. Catherine Nicol. Sarah Oliphant. Kimberly Patterson. Alex Reed. Neve Robertson. Lauren Rogers. Jade Sangster. Estelle Sheck. Martha Sherbin. Chloe Simpson. Amanda Smith. Catherine Suter. Rebecca Stewart. Callie Taylor. Lucy Taylor. Abby Thompson. Madeline Ward. And for the degree of Bachelor of Arts, for Kanda Sheikh. Amy Archibald. Lauren Barclay. Jacqueline Black. Paige Bryson. Sarah Donaldson. Kiva Duncan. Kirsten Forrest. Sylvie Gourley. Zoe Graham. Nicole Gracie. Zoe Graham. Tracy Hilditch. Danielle Johnson. Michelle Kay. Martine Keith. Caitlin Knox. Megan Lawson. Rebecca Lennox. Nicole Livingston. Stephanie Lord. Emma McAllister. Jamie Lee McDonald. Kirsten McFarlane. Rachel McGarrity. Gillian McUravey. Siobhan McLeod. Rebecca Moultrie. Niamh O'Leary. Anne-Marie Partington. Rachel Rennie. Amy Robb. Amanda Scott. Caroline Scott. Kirsty Stewart. Melissa Stewart. Karis Torrey. Karen Weir. Kerry White. Lauren Wishart. Yeah. Linda Young. Marta Zukowska. Michelle Sorby. And for the degree of Bachelor of Laws, Akko Abdul Mohammed. Emmanuel Alcarafor. Michael Pauls. Rohit Verdi. L. Norton Armstrong. Alexandros Ortiz. And Hannah Rhodes. Thank you.
We'll now hear from the university choir.
Thank you.
we thank the choir for that musical interlude. Always brilliant for us. I now call on Carrie McLennan from the School of Humanities, Social Sciences and Law to present the candidates.
Chancellor, I have the honour to present for the Postgraduate Certificate in Education into Headship, Ashley Brown. Ryan Laird. Ashley Matheson. Louise Riggs. Wendy Sinclair. Lindsay Smith. Karen Taylor. And for the Postgraduate Certificate in International Education, Asma Hassanain. For the Postgraduate Certificate in Leading Learning and Teaching, Diana Issa. For the Postgraduate Certificate in Nursery Early Education, Leah Kayesi. For the Postgraduate Diploma in Law, Rashi Gupta. For the Postgraduate Diploma in Leading Learning and Teaching, Andrew Okoro. Mercy Savoeda. For the Postgraduate Diploma in Professional Legal Practice, Alexander Anderson. Katie Anderson. Brindis Blackadder. Katie Brown. Matthew Bruce. Alana Bryant. Jennifer Burton. Megan Callahan. Ruth Campbell. Alexander Kazali. Ewan Chalmers. Gordon Chalmers. Aaron Clark. Joshua Cullen. Rachel Durward. Gary Ellingford. Rosa Ferry. Kayla Gardner. Shayna Gillespie. Rory Guild. Harriet Hearns. Daniel Henry. Christopher Horn. Daisy Johnston. David Kay. Stephen Keir. Phoebe King. Regina Carotti. Kelsey Laird. Victoria Lee. Charles Leuvenink. Annie MacDonald. James MacDonald. Phoebe MacDonald. Daisy McNiven. Erin McPhee. Edward Mullen-Sappi. Callum McCormack. Olivia McGowan. Amy McKee. Ewan McPhee. Summer Meekison. Nicole Melville. Rachel Menzies. Emma Milne. Laura Minto. Callum Monroe. Fabrizio Palmucci. Ewan Robinson. Stuart Rogers. Myri Ross. Aisha Sattar. Christy Stenson. Catherine Sterling. Adriana Struss. Thomas Sweeney. Ryan Timms. Jack Ward. Jack Wilson. Fatmata Wuri. And for the Professional Graduate Diploma in Primary Education, Monica Siska. Charlotte Clark. Sarah Edwards. Chantel Kelby. Marion McGowan. Frances McLean. Emma Smith. Shannon Stewart. Tony Stewart. Adam Taylor. And for the Master of Education, Nesrin Al-Alali. Abir Al-Jiran. Jill Keyes. May Salim. Kariman Soliman. Joseph White. Saima Bashir. Emily Loudon. Siham Kasabri. Lisa Swanson. Gurpreet Kaur. Ravinder Kaur. Fatima Malik. Fatima Razak. Omoshala Abiodun Ogunremi. Ansi Abraham. Ifeok Ademiluwa. Dolapo Adeniran. Ruth Adesanmi. Polakemi Adetoru. Sakuntala Mudiyanselagi. Omolola Agunbiade. Umotola Akindolani. William Aluko. Archana Taralakshmi. Olamide Ateri. Adedotsun Ayodeji. Randy Madonna. Leslie Berry. Priyanka Bhala. Insia Bhavna Garwala. Basma Borokini Onavali. Inusha Chandrasena. Douglas Cunningham. Suzanne Davies. Ranula de Souza. Patricia Digia. Chaturika Mudiyanselagi. Gayani Mudiyanselaga. Ebudu Isioma Ebudu. Iman El Wardi. Precious Ezetuku. Yantra Fernando. Christelle Grief. Guroshika Hagara Piti Yarachi. Dulanjana Gedara. Kandabaji Hevavi Tarana. Chidima Ibe. Zihan Jailabdin. Delupa Arachige. Ashinshani Kaloraci. Maheshika Arachilagi. Yatusala Kirutihan. Amendra Mudiyanselagi. Sajika Liana Gamaji. Ravi Kumar. Singapulile Kamge. Dulangika Lianagi. Chan Lu. Niruba Masilan. Joshua Martin. Jane Mays. Hansini Nisankage. Eyewumi Njoku. Nikem Ofwebu. Angela Obekilu. Adeyemi Ogunrotifa. Olabisi Ojajuni. Adetsun Ojo. Belinda Okocha. Oluwasola Olasuyi. Temitope Olukolojo. Odunayo Uluwafemi. Rukayat Otsun. Sandra Palmer. Gitika Vatvitana. Dora Paranetu. Jennifer Paul. Rini Philip. Joanne Philp. Netmi Arachilagi. Aishat Rufai. Olabode Salau. Aparna Saxena. Imesha Siriwardena. Navodia Subasinghe. Sobia Tabish. Rajkumar Chata. Adisha Varnakula Surya. Gidava Iresha Virasinghe. Gedara Lavanga Virasinghe. Herat Velevita. Eranga Vijesinghe. Indiwari Abiwardena. Asma Yusuf. Olabisi Yusuf. Onokunle Adewumi. Titilope Dada. Titilope Dada. Flavia Godja. Ridma Mudiyanselagi. Tratmi Nguyen. Neha Seti. Solomon Taiwo. Sadima Mudiyanselagi. Minxing Shui. And for the Master of Laws, Chimaijim Eze. Marizujuku Ojeniyi. Rashmi Vijesiri. Gayatri Yogaratnam. Yogesh. Doyinsola Adebenle. Olamide Amau. Chinimerem Ayubu. Takunda Chipeta. Mohamed Farouk. Asra Irshad. Lalit Kibarpanti. Sunaina Mudara. Dinesh Kumar Premanand. Nitin Sharma. Ariana Folino. Gemma Darragh. Sharon Kyle. Aideen O'Kane. Papawi Bunchon Prapun. Ketkao Gajina. Samuel Lincoln Bassi. Sirafat Pratam Pitak. Vanessa Semugaza. Temiloluwa Fon. Haley Agampodi. O'Brien Aloysius. Stephanie Annie Boise. Fatima Ashruf. Linda Gobadia. Kioma Obi. Temitope Odesola. Nkechinyere Ortuanya. Grace Oyelola. Grant Tony Imagery. Yasita Udagamami Lianagi. And for the Master of Science, Janelle Muir. And for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Rasha Alshakshir.
I now call on the Assistant Vice Principal Education, Professor Nick Brewer.
Chancellor, I have the honour to present for the Chancellor's Award for Outstanding Contribution to Teaching, Professor Andrea Ross.
Forgotten this to do with that. As Chancellor, I confer upon you the Chancellor's Award in recognition of outstanding achievement and contributions to teaching. Congratulations. Yeah. Come on. Thank you.
Okay.
Pleasure. I now call on Professor Kim Dale to present the honorary graduate for the degree of Doctor of Laws. Stand up.
Chancellor, I have the honor to present for the degree of Doctor of Laws, honoris causa, Dr. Sabir Zazai. I stand here proud to say that true to our mission and our values, our university is a university of sanctuary, which makes us part of a network of universities working together to make higher education institutions in the UK places of safety, solidarity, and empowerment for people seeking sanctuary. We're completely committed to engaging and supporting sanctuary seekers in many different ways, providing a welcoming environment for our sanctuary students, ring-fencing humanitarian scholarship funds to provide financial support to incoming refugee and asylum-seeking students, and seeking to work with individuals and communities beyond the campus to promote and support the principles of sanctuary. Our work in the humanitarian and sanctuary space is inspired by some of those we work with. Dr. Sabir Zazai is prime amongst those individuals, and we were delighted and thrilled that Dr. Sabir presented our university with our University of Sanctuary Award. Dr. Sabir is an activist and campaigner who has dedicated his whole life to securing the rights and improving the lives of refugees and asylum seekers. His own story illustrates the difficulties that sadly affect so many people around the world. Lives thrown into chaos through war, conflict, and displacement. Born and raised in Kabul, Sabir's peaceful life was thrown into chaos after the outbreak of war in 1992. His family lived for years in a United Nations refugee camp on the border with Pakistan, with millions of other displaced Afghans. He endured months of danger and hardship traveling across Europe in search of safety, arriving in Britain in 1999. Sabir was welcomed to Coventry by a small charity today known as the Coventry Refugee and Migration Centre. After learning English at the local college, he went to work as a language assistant in a local school. He went on and attended Coventry University, where he gained a master's degree in community cohesion management. From his earliest days in the UK, Sabir was determined to give back to the community which had helped him and to support others in similar situations. Sabir established the Afghan Society of Coventry to ensure that other refugees could establish their new lives with confidence. He brought both his lived experience and voluntary experience to his professional life, with roles at the Coventry Refugee and Migration Centre, Voluntary Action Coventry, and the Citizens Advice Bureau. 15 years after arriving in Coventry, Sabir was appointed Chief Executive Officer at the Coventry Refugee and Migration Centre, the very organisation which had helped set him on his path to success. He continued to play a wider role in his country by serving as a trustee on the council at Coventry Cathedral, as vice chair of the Coventry Ethnic Minorities Action Partnership, and as chair and later trustee of the UK City of Sanctuary. For the past 7 years, he's served as chief executive of the Scottish Refugee Council. The council offers direct assistance to those fleeing conflict and abuse, assisting them with everything from housing and health to education and employment. A tireless campaigner for dignity and democracy, for social justice and social change, Sabir has been honoured with Fellowship of the Royal Society of Edinburgh and with an OBE by Her Majesty the Queen in 2022. At a time when forced migration, whether the result of war, persecution, or climate change, is only on the increase, Sabir's leadership demonstrates how and why a compassionate and welcoming response is vital. Sabir has shown that lives need not be completely ruined, but that with resilience and determination, a new life can emerge. Having spent decades helping others along this path, Sabir is an inspiration to us all. So it could not be more fitting that Sabir joins us today, the 20th of June, 2024, which marks the World Refugee Day. Chancellor, I have the honor to invite you to confer upon Sabir Zazai the degree of Doctor of Laws.
I tell you. Bye. Actually do the degree. Here. By the authority of the Senate, I confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Laws. Here.
It was 1992. And all of a sudden, we ended up in the basement of our family home. The bombing got closer and closer and louder, and the debris started falling. And our grandmother was next to us, and she was worried for us, for the children. And the only shield that she had was her scarf. And she put that around us because she was worried that we may perish in that terrible war in Afghanistan. Today, she would have been very proud to see me to receive an honorary degree. She wanted us to survive. My parents, their only hope for us was survival, not what form of education we receive, or which school or which university we go to. The only hope for us was surviving a dreadful war. Friends, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, as we gather here today in this magnificent hall to celebrate your futures and your careers, there are people in their millions around the world who denied peace, who denied justice, and who denied fair access to education and other rights. We're in a fortunate place and situation for all of you to capitalize and benefit from the peace, the prosperity, and the education that you have achieved here. My life, like many others, was shattered by the conflict in Afghanistan. I arrived in the UK in the back of a lorry. I only had 7 years of formal education. Some might say I haven't had much to offer to this country. But I arrived with my dream and my hope and aspirations to do well and be part of this great country and make a contribution. I received a warm welcome from many people who just only treated me as a fellow human being and offered me that warm welcome and sanctuary. Today is World Refugee Day, and there are millions of people around the globe who are forced to flee their homes because of war, because of conflict, because of human rights violations. But most importantly, it's not their mistake, it's none of their mistake. They're forced to flee their homes due to no mistake of their own. There's no difference between refugees and between you and I. The only difference is that they have lost everything they once had. And we all are in that privileged position to reach a hand of friendship and solidarity and offer people that very warm welcome. People might say people come here for housing. In Afghanistan, we didn't have a housing system. People might say I came for jobs. In Afghanistan, we didn't have a jobs system. People might say people come for benefits. No, we haven't had a benefit system as well. I came for safety, and many others come for safety too. And all we can do is to treat them with dignity, decency, and respect, and tell them that you're so very much welcome here. When we truly welcome people, and when we treat them as fellow human beings, and when we offer them their rights, this is what happens. So I had the great honor to be able to turn my own experiences of suffering and loss into hope for others. And that is where I find meaning in life, when I see people like myself arriving here with hopes and aspirations, but with deep fears as well. And I tell them that I have been through this as well, and so you will, and you will have your lives here. So for me, this degree is such a great privilege that I've been recognized at this level. This is not for me. This is for all refugees. This is for people who offer protection and sanctuary to people fleeing wars and persecution. This degree is to my family who are here, my lovely family, and my colleagues at Scottish Refugee Council. Thank you. And I'm so grateful to University of Dundee. You're a welcoming place for people, no matter where they've come from, no matter what route people have taken. It's where we're going that really matters. And the University of Dundee knows where it's heading. It is the University of Sanctuary, and I was proud to provide that honor to the university. And I did say to Ian that you don't need a paper to be a welcoming university, you're already welcoming. And thank you for all that you do to tell your students that they're welcome here. So I couldn't have received this honor on a better day. Today is World Refugee Day, and I'm also wearing the Scottish Refugee Council charter. So it's the Scottish Refugee Council Tartan, it's the World Refugee Day, it's the University of Sanctuary. I'm just thinking it might be a dream. I have to scratch myself. Because this is what happens when people mix their cultures, bring their unique values and talents, but also embrace the values of their new homes and their new communities, and feel that they're an important part of our society. So I want to say huge thanks to the university and to the Senate, but also to all the students as well. We all have so much to do. And going back to that basement that made me emotional in 1992, our grandmother was very close to us, and she will always pray for us. But she knew why she was praying in that way, because we live in a world where humans can do some really terrible things to one another. And she will always say, may you come across good people. So, in closing, I want to leave you all with that prayer of my grandmother, which is also a prayer of people on the move, people uprooted from their homes and families, that may you all come across good people in your own careers, and may you be good to others, because whether it's politics, whether it's engineering, whether it's environment, we need good people. We need decency in politics, we need decency in all aspects of our life. Fear is not going to make us safe. Only hope can make us safe. Hope, love, and compassion. So Ian was talking me into doing a dance. So I'm not doing the dance, but I'm very good at creating a very good cheer. So I am going to say it loud, say it clear. Refugees are welcome here. Say it loud, say it clear. Refugees are welcome here. Say it loud, say it clear. Refugees are welcome here. Thank you.
You better acknowledge. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much, Sabia, for these inspiring thoughts on this rather remarkable day. I now call upon the Principal and Vice-Chancellor to address you.
Chancellor, I have the honour to present... No, I don't. I could. We could do a dance together, Zabir. What do you think? Maybe we need to practice that. Maybe that's one for the garden party. Yeah. Okay, back to the script. This time. Chancellor, I have the honour to invite you to confer the degrees in absence upon the candidates who have been unable to attend this ceremony.
By the authority of the Senate, I confer these degrees.
Well, graduates, that means you too, Zabir. You're the kind of most recent graduate of the University of Dundee. So pay attention. Have you had fun?
Well.
Have you had fun? That's a bit better. Listen, we've got two things to do before you all head off to the garden party. And is the sun still shining out there, Sean? Yeah, the sun's still shining. That's good news. So the first thing to do is, actually, it picks up on our Arnie graduate's comments about his grandmother. We don't all have grandmothers, but we all have friends, families, loved ones, and of course, superb teachers. So please join me in thanking all of them for the support they've shown you and your children. Now, our honorary graduate has inspired us about who we are as a university, our social purpose. And I can't possibly do more than that. So therefore, I have to turn to my very last task of this ceremony. And that's to win the bet with the Chancellor. So, to close the ceremony, before we push to the Chancellor, who of course has the rights over everything, I want to ensure we give ourselves a really big send-off with the class of 2024 giving the biggest Dundee cheer ever heard in this hall. And it's on three. I'm going to count you in. Three, two, one. Let's go!
Almost as loud as the cheers of relief at the end of the football game last night, I think. Thank you very much for that. And the Chancellor and I will consult all the calibrated machines that tell us what the noise levels were at the various graduations. And now, can I ask you all to be upstanding? And I declare that this academic ceremony is closed.